Hi there, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to the series Real-Time Music and Sound with Pure Data. In this episode, we're going to be looking at Polymeter. So what do we mean by Polymeter? We're looking at a kind of music where each part sounds as if it's in a different meter. In this example, the bottom part is in 4/4. It has repetition in lots of 4. We've got accents on the downbeat, so we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so forth. The top part, even though in this particular notation it's written in 4/4, it's going to sound like it's in a pattern of 5. We get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. So we get the apparent sense that there are 2 meters happening at once, a meter of 4 against a meter of 5. So what's important here is that the pulses are the same duration, but the length of the sequences are different. You'll see that eventually they will all align up again. In this case, after we get 5 repetitions of 4 or 4 repetitions of 5, we'll be back again at the starting point. So it's important that you distinguish polymeter from another thing which has a similar name, polyrhythm, where, say, we had 4 against 5 as a polyrhythm. The 5 pattern, each step would be slightly shorter than they are, so that we match up at the end of the single cycle. Whereas in polymeter, all of the steps are the same duration and they don't match up again until after several repetitions. All right, let's see how we implement this. So polymeter, of course, is a straightforward sequence. And in this series, we've done a number of sequences before. So I might take some shortcuts just to save us a little bit of time. So I've created this subpatch called clock, which I'll show you here. It has a metronome, which is in beats per minute, and there's an inlet for the beats per minute, and then, like most sequences, there's a counter. We've got a floating point number box incremented by 1 every time, and that's outlet. So this particular subpatch will take a toggle to start it, and it will take a number in here, which is going to be the beats per minute. So that's might go from, say, 40 up to a maximum of, say, 300 would be a reasonable range, beats per minute. Okay. If we put a bang out of that, we will see that that's what happens. We can change the speed accordingly by changing the beats per minute, like so. Okay, so that's giving us actually a count, and if we put a number box here, we'll see that we're getting an incremented count. The other thing that happens in a sequence is that we will use the modulo function to repeat the cycle. So for example, if we had a modulo of 4, then we put a number box after that, we'll see that we just get 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3. So we just get a 4-step sequence that goes on like so. In this particular example, we want to be able to change that number of steps in the cycle. So I'm going to use a number box to do that, to specify that. So any number that goes in here will, of course, override this default value of 4. It's also quite handy to visualize this. We can use a H-radio button to show us those steps as they go. If we increase that, we can see that the steps increase. It's kind of handy if this H-radio button also changes its size to correspond with the length of the sequence. So to do that, we can use a command number and pass it in the number of steps as a variable, so that when we then change this, we also change the size. We can specify that we're going to get one will be our shortest sequence, and let's just say arbitrarily that 16 will be our longest. Right, so then we can adjust that as we need to, as it's going. All right, so far so good. If we wanted to do this quite straightforwardly, we could just simply play a particular pitch, let's say MIDI note number 60, and we'll play that out to some kind of synthesizer. Again, because we've done this a few times before in this video series, I'll just use a sub patch which I've prepared, and I can show you what that looks like. You can hear it there. It's just a single sine tone oscillator with a very quick amplitude envelope using V-line to do that. That's converting the MIDI pitch into a frequency using the MIDI to frequency object. So the problem here though is that we don't actually know the pitch number, so let me instead of using a fixed note of 60, I'm going to instead increment it chromatically to 60 as a bass. So now we have pitches rising from 60. And you can hear that as we change the number of steps, then it keeps returning to 60 on the downbeat. Alright, so that's 1 meter, one part. So what we can do is basically duplicate this process for a second part. Grab all of that, copy it and paste it over here, get the clock to also go there. And so now if we specify, for example, 4 steps there and 5 steps here, I might change this to be an octave higher, so that we can more clearly distinguish the two parts. And we can dynamically change like so. And so now we've set up parts with different lengths, their sequences of different lengths. They'll play at the same speed per step, and we can hear that they're different. If you watched some of the sequencing with arrays episodes earlier in this series, you'll see how you can specify a particular pitch sequence in order to replace this simple chromatic ascending tone. But I'll leave that to you as an exercise to elaborate on this, and see you in another video.